What's going on, guys? Infinity EOC back again, and today it's going to be my Emerald City Comic Con haul. Got a lot of stuff. I spent way more money than I thought I would or that I was planning on, but that kind of always happens for me at cons, especially this year because I went all 3 days. So there was a lot to buy and a lot of money to be spent. But I got a lot of awesome stuff, and it's pretty cool. Everything I got is pretty cool. So let's just get into it. I know you want to see what I got, see some exclusives and stuff I got. And that's what I'm going to show first. So first thing I did I got there Friday morning. First thing I did was get into the merch line for the ECCC exclusive merch stuff, because that stuff always sells out. And I wanted to get a few things, and one of the things I got was this tote bag here. It's nothing really crazy, it's just a bag. It's got the logo on there for the Comic-Con. And, you know, I just wanted to get this just to have some extra carrying room. It's a pretty good quality bag. It's like one of those shopping bags that you'd get at the grocery store. But yeah, it's pretty cool. And it came with this manila envelope of random swag. It says Swagvelope. So yeah, there's another reason to buy it. It was only $5. You get the bag and you get this bag of random things too. So, my random stuff wasn't that great though. It was a copy of, Masks number one. The Comic-Con exclusive from last year cover, and I bought this last year at the con for $5, and then I get one for free here, so I have two of these now. That kind of sucked, but whatever. I got this random book called Hounded. I don't know what this is. It's probably, it's not going to get read. I can tell you that right now. I'm not going to read this, but yeah, it's the first book in the Iron Druid Chronicles, whatever the hell that means. So, little novel, not going to be reading that. Some advertisements, there's another advertisement card. And then, that was it. And then I got two temporary tattoos of, like, the Comic-Con logo. Oh, it's upside down. Like that. Yeah, so temporary tattoo. So my swag bag wasn't really that great, but you know, what can you do? So that was the first thing I got in that line. The second thing I got in that line was the reason I stood in the line to begin with, and that's this Monsters and Dames art book. Every year Emerald City does these art books. This is a 2014 book, and it's just like different pinup pictures of Monsters and Dames, I guess. Like, see, there's always a girl and a monster in one of the pictures. And a lot of some of the artists in this book were at the con, and you could have them sign the picture or whatever. I didn't get them signed. I didn't get any pictures signed. But it's just a really nice book. It's like 50 pages maybe. I don't know exactly, but it's limited to 1,150, and I got number 317, so it's pretty awesome. I'm glad I got this book. Yeah, it's the whole reason why I stood in that line. The line didn't go too slow. It went pretty quickly. And then the other thing I got in the line, was, since I was already waiting in the line, I figured I'd pick this up too, is Tales of the Con. This is just like it's like a one panel. This isn't like a story or anything. It's just like one panel comics of like different experiences that people have at the convention. And it's just kind of silly, just like different things. Like here's one panel. Let's see. And the best thing is when I go to sell my collection, all these babies are going to be in mint condition. Yeah, he's got digital comics. You know, it's just like one panel shots is like, you know, silly, stupid stuff like that. So I got that, and that's pretty cool. Here's the program. I wanted to show this at the beginning, but I forgot. This is the program to the convention. It's really nice, paper stock. It's just like comic book size. Like, you can bag and board this. It's pretty sweet. And then the cover is cool. It's got, like, it's almost like a search and find of, like, different comic book characters going up the escalators to the show floor that they have at the convention center there. So, this is cool. And then, so that's all I got in that first line there. And then, more exclusives that I got at the show. In the programs, they're actually handing this book out. It's a Walking Dead number one. So I got this for free. They're just tucked in the programs, which is awesome. It's just a variant cover, Comic-Con exclusive. There's the logo up there. 2014 exclusive cover of Walking Dead number one. So yeah, that was an awesome little treat. Free book. Free exclusive, even. And then next one I got is the exclusive cover of Batman number 29. It's the same cover as the original one. It's just instead of black, it's white. And then it's got the little Comic-Con logo down here. So this was a nice book. I went to the Dark Horse booth, and I got this exclusive cover of The Witcher number 1 of 5, I believe it is. Yep, number 1 of 5. They had these at the Dark Horse booth. And this doesn't have the Comic-Con logo on it, but this is the exclusive Comic-Con cover. And then also at the Dark Horse booth, I got a copy of Veil number 1 with the exclusive cover. It's her eyes right there. That's how it looks. So I read this already, and this is great. And I actually just picked up number 2 this week at the shop. So glad I got this. Glad I got this cool exclusive cover. And then my favorite exclusive that I got is Five Ghosts number 10, the exclusive Comic-Con cover. They have the little Emerald City 2014 exclusive variant. I bought this from Frank Barbary himself, and he signed it for me right up here. This is awesome. This cover is incredible. I love this cover so much. And yeah, so I bought that off Frank Barbary himself, and because I bought that, he gave me the Phantom variant of number 7, just for free. It's a free copy of the Phantom variant for number 7, and he signed this one also. It's over here. I don't know if you can see it very well. Yeah, right there. It's just a little chicken scratch signature. It's real quick. But yeah, he's a great guy. He signed that for me. And then, because he's such a great guy, I told him I needed number 8 to complete my run, and he gave me a copy of number 8. He didn't charge anything for this, which I thought was awesome. And then he signed this one too, up here in silver pen. I don't know if you can see that very well though. But yeah, so he gave me a copy of number 8, which, thank you, Frank. That was amazing. And then, to top it off, I was like, man, I don't want to be an asshole or anything, but could you sign my entire run of Five Ghosts? And he was like, yeah, sure, no problem. So I brought my run, and he signed every copy, 1 through 10. And here's his signature up here. That's number 1. Here's number 2. He signed that up down here. I'm not going to go through them all, but it's right here. He signed them all. Here's number 10. He signed in silver. I can't really even see it. It's right there. Yeah, so he signed my entire run of Five Ghosts. So I have 1 through 10 signed by him, the Phantom variant of number 7 signed by him, and the exclusive variant of number 10 signed by him, which was awesome. And then, so I went over later to the Dark Horse booth, and I bought his other book, The White Suits, number 1. And I was going to have him sign it, but I went back to his table, and he wasn't there. So I didn't get a chance for him to sign this one, too. But yeah, I'm looking forward to reading this one. I haven't read this one yet, but I'm sure it'll be good. It's Frank Barbary. And then I was over at the Oni Press booth, and I bought a book that I heard. I think Oddfellows reads this book, and he said it was really good. And a few other guys read it, I'm sure. And that's The Bunker, number one. This is the second print. They had a variant copy of number one, but it was $10, and I didn't really want to spend the money on it. I don't know. I just felt like I should just buy the second printing of number one. So I bought second printing of number one, and then I got number two also, straight from the Oni Press booth. So that's pretty cool. That's really all like the current stuff I bought. Everything else is more like back issue. Okay. So moving on. Show this off real fast. This is a nice hardcover I got from Fantagraphics. This is Wally Wood's Canon. It's like a serialized American James Bond kind of deal that was like, it was only printed in military magazines for military bases. And it's just full of like war. It's got like war stories and just a bunch of stuff. It's got what does it say on the back? Undercover and under the covers, Canon endures torture by beautiful women, explosive gunplay, naked catfights, bone crunching plastic surgery, Hitler, nihilistic lovemaking, nuclear bombs, Weasel the Spy, naked women, death from above, and more naked women. That's literally what this says on the back. That's awesome. So this is pretty cool. I went to the Fantagraphics booth, and they actually didn't even have a copy of it. This just came out like a month ago. This printing, at least. They had sold their copies of it already, and so I had to buy this from another guy who actually had it on sale. So if I bought it from Fantagraphics, I probably would have paid the full $35. But this guy was selling his for like $30, so I was able to get this for $5 off. Really nice book. It's pretty thick. Yeah, so glad I got that. I've actually been looking for that for a while now. And then let's get into some more stuff. Actually, I bought this from the same guy I bought that that Canon book from. And these are kind of weird. This is something I typically wouldn't buy, but they're pretty cheap. And I'm a sucker for cheap things, and I'm a sucker for like weird-ass obscure things that, and this is kind of what this is. So this is a book called Betty Page in Danger. It's like the pin-up Betty Page, like pictures of her in a comic form. Like they're actually little photographs, and it's got like comic bubbles, like someone like had made a story out of the photographs. So that's pretty cool. I got issues 2, 3, 4, 5. These got a price tag of $9.95 on them, and I paid $2 a piece. And it's pretty cool. Like they come with 3D glasses. Like at the end of each issue, they have like a model. Like this girl here. It's like a Playboy or whatever. The back of it is, and her pictures are in 3D, so they give you glasses for it. So that's cool. It was cool to find those. I looked up some more online of them, and I guess there was like 12 issues. I'd never heard of it before, but I thought it was pretty cool for $2 a piece. Let's go through this huge stack of comics now. So I found this booth. I spent like 4 hours there digging through boxes, but I love doing that, so I could do that all day. And he had 3 for $1 books. So I
I walked away with a huge stack.
This whole stack right here. They were all three for a dollar. So. I didn't buy all these at once, actually. I bought some of them on, like, Friday. I bought some of them on Saturday. And I bought some on Sunday. Like, I kept going back. But, yeah, let's just get through them all, because there's a lot. First one is Infinity 6 of 6. I actually never got this. I missed this in the shop, and I've read it digitally since, but this is the first time I have a print copy. Here's one, Batman Doc Savage crossover. It's pretty cool, both awesome characters from Brian Azzarello. Yeah. Here is Denny O'Neill's Doc Savage miniseries, number one. Number two. Number three. And number four. Here's a cool one. The Phantom, number one. This is one of four, I think. Yeah, from 1988. One of four. James Bond. 007, Permission to Die, number one. X-Men Spotlight on the Starjammers, one of two. I'll get these out of the way. One of six, Kitty Pryde and Wolverine. A lot of these are just like random-ass books. Black Condor, number one. Fist of Khonshu, Moon Knight, number one. Forgotten Realms Annual, number one. American Flag, Howard Chaykin's American Flag, volume two, number one. This one I pretty much just bought for the cover. I don't collect this series. Incredible Hulk 362, awesome Werewolf by Night cover. This was an awesome find, too. This is The Demon, number 10, in the $3 for $1 box. I mean, it's not in the greatest of shape, but I don't really care about condition in any of my books, really. As long as it's not, like gum stuck to them or something, you know? Detective 625. Batman the movie adaptation. This is a weird one. Dracula versus Zorro from Topps Comics. I kind of just got that because it's weird. Uncanny X-Men 306. Uncanny X-Men 293. Uncanny X-Men 319. I believe this one's... Yep. Uncanny X-Men 193. Uncanny X-Men 216. Uncanny X-Men Annual number 7. This book I didn't buy. Well, I did buy it, but I didn't want to buy it. I don't know why I bought this. I'm not collecting this volume at all. But Uncanny X-Men Annual number 1. This is from Chris Claremont. I think this is like from 2004, 2006. Yeah, I'm not even sure what this run was, or what run this annual's from, but yeah, that was kind of just in there, the filler. X-Men number 70, X-Men 69, X-Men 73, X-Men 72, Web of Spider-Man 71. Yeah, so a lot of these books are just, like, hole fillers for runs I'm trying to collect. Spider-Man 66. Peter Parker Spectacular Spider-Man 61. Peter Parker Spectacular Spider-Man 111. Peter Parker Spectacular Spider-Man 88. Peter Parker Spectacular Spider-Man 94. Ultimate War number 3. Ultimate War number 2. Ultimate X-Men 74. Ultimate X-Men 73. Ultimate X-Men 66, Ultimate X-Men 65, Ultimate Fantastic Four 29, Ultimate Fantastic Four 28, Ultimate Fantastic Four 27. Yep, so a lot of those, actually all those were just hole fillers. Okay, these next few books are Epic Comics. These are by Chris Claremont and John Bolton, Black Dragon, number 2. I picked up number 1 at MegaCon last week, and here I found the whole series. So, 2 of 6. 3 of 6. 4 of 6, 5 of 6, and 6 of 6. So I got the whole Black Dragon miniseries now, which is awesome. This is a book that I kind of just saw. It was Epic Comics. It was a number 1. I don't really know what this is, but it's the Boz Chronicles. But, you know, 3 for a dollar. Not bad. And this is a series that looks pretty terrible, to tell you the truth. But I picked up the first 8 issues. It's another Epic Comics. It's Sisterhood of Steel, number 1. Number 2. Number 3. Number 4. Number 5. Number 6. Number 7, and number 8. So, yeah, this is by Christy Marks, which I enjoyed her Sword of Sorcery in New 52. But, yeah, I don't know. We'll see how that goes. I'm sure it's not that great. These next books are books that kind of just... A lot of this stuff I was going through here, and I realized that I picked up a lot of fantasy. Like Black Dragon, Sisterhood of Steel, and then more fantasy just kept coming up, just kept, you know, piquing my interest. And this stack right here is even more fantasy. It kind of was unintentional, but whatever. Here's Dragonlance number 1. Dragonlance number 2. Dragonlance number 3. Here's Amethyst, Princess of Gemworld, number 1. And number 1. Amethyst, number 2. Princess of Gemworld, number 3. Princess of Gemworld, number 4. Princess of Gemworld, number 5. Princess of Gemworld, number 6. So, yeah, I really liked... The New 52 Sword of Amethyst Sword of Sorcery book, and you know, I didn't read the 80s stuff, so figured I'd give that a chance. And then this was another awesome find too, Sword of Sorcery number 1 in the three for a dollar bin. So glad I picked that up. And then these books right here, these are for you, Rick. I'm sending these to you, because I know you need them. Here's Ragman number 1 of 8. And then Ragman number 3 of 8. So, that's, I think you need 2 more now from that run you started at MegaCon. So those books will be in the mail for you shortly. And then, here's Fantastic Four Annual number 20. Fantastic Four 274. Fantastic Four 253, Fantastic Four Annual 18, Fantastic Four Annual 17, Mephisto vs. Fantastic Four, number 1, Mephisto vs. X-Factor, number 2, and Mephisto vs. X-Men, number 3. So that's it. That's all the three for a dollar books I got. That was a pretty large stack. but you know, for three for a dollar, I'll take my time to rummage through the boxes. He had like 20 long boxes I had to go through. It was insane. No order to anything.
All right, so the next
few books are trades that I got. Most of these were pretty cheap. There's a few I paid full price for, but I'll let you know when we get to them. So these books right here, these were a dollar a piece, and these are really cool, actually. They're Tarzan books. Tarzan the Lost Adventure. Okay, so it's like the beginning of the book is all like novelized, okay? And then at the end of the book, it's got John Carter of Mars comics. It's probably like the last fourth of the book is John Carter of Mars comics. And this is all like one continuous story. Okay, there's four books here. And yeah, they're a dollar a piece. There's book one of four. There's two of four. Three of four. And four of four. And yeah, they're all like novelizations. It's all one continuous story. And yeah, like book four of four starts out with, you know, chapter 18 on the first page. So, you know, you gotta get all of them to read the whole story. So this is really cool. These will look really nice on the shelf. They're by Dark Horse. And yeah. Excited to read those. Next trades I got. These are kind of trades. These were all a dollar a piece also. They're like old trades. I guess they're kind of trades, more like just like story arcs. Well, I guess whatever, that's what trade is. But I don't like Marvel and DC put these out like in the early 90s and the 80s and maybe even earlier than that. They're just like real thin. I don't know if these are original stories or not or if they were collections, but this Wolverine Reign of Terra or Ron of Terra. These are all dollar piece, really small trades. Here's Ghost Rider, Captain America, Fear. Which is really weird because it's got Scarecrow in it. But I'm not sure if it's the DC Scarecrow. It's probably not. Because that wouldn't make any sense, but I don't know what that is. Ghost Rider, Wolverine, Punisher. Hearts of Darkness. And then Batman, Green Arrow, The Poison Tomorrow. So those are cool for a dollar piece. Then I picked up Ultimate Fantastic Four Volume 5. I think this was $5. This was a dollar also. Speed Racer Classics Volume 1. It's just like old Speed Racer books from, I think it's from Now. Yep, Now Comics. From the 80s, I'm sure. I don't know when this is from. Yep, 88. This one's pretty cool, too. This is, I believe it's the Complete Armor Wars from Iron Man. This is really old printing. But I got this for, like, $3. You know, it's the classic Armor Wars story. And, like, the original trade, it seems. The original printing. Yeah, it's Iron Man 225 through 332. So there's a lot of content in here for pretty cheap. This book I got is really weird. It's called Spider-Man Unmasked. It's a kind of a trade. It's like trade size, but it's pretty much just like little bios on people from the Spider-Man universe. Like it's like the back of like it's like a collection of the back of trading cards almost. I don't know. It was pretty cool. It was only a dollar, so why not? Here's Volume 6 of Amazing Spider-Man, of JMS's Amazing Spider-Man. I needed this one. I still need two more. I think I need 1 and 3 or something. Here's DC Universe Online Legends, Volume 2. I had number 1, and now I got number 2. This is cool. This is Rat Queens, Volume 1. I actually met Curtis Weeb, and I got him to to sign this. I bought this directly from Curtis Weeb. Here's Curtis Weeb's signature, and Rock Up Church was sitting right next to him, the artist. So they both signed it. I went over to his booth. He was right next to Frank Barbary's booth. And so I saw him when I was talking to Frank. And I went over to Curtis, and I told him how much I liked Peter Panzerfaust. And he was like, oh, yeah, I'd read Rat Queens yet. And I said, no, I heard it's awesome, though. And so I just bought the trade right off him right there. And then he signed it for me. So this is cool. I'm excited to read this. I hear it's really good. And yeah, Curtis was a great guy. This next book I bought, so I bought Rat Queens for full price. I bought this next book for full price, too, because I bought it directly from Boom. That's Suicide Risk. I heard this was a great book, too. I forget who was talking about this book. This may have been Oddfellow's thoughts also that reads this book and said it was pretty good. You know, I'm sorry if it wasn't you, but I think it was. Yeah, I'm looking forward to reading this book. It seems pretty cool. It's about like this group of cops that fight superheroes, and they're pretty much the suicide team, because how can they beat the heroes? Or the villains, I guess, they would be fighting. This next book I got is bought directly from Image, Satellite Sam, number one. I've been wanting to read this for a while also, and it finally got collected in trade maybe a month or two ago. And so I've been meaning to pick it up, and so I did. And I was gonna go talk to Matt Fraction, have him sign it, but I really didn't have anything to say to him. I hadn't read this yet, so I still haven't read it, but I don't know. Next books I got these pretty cheap. I got these for $6 a piece. Why the Last Man, Volume 2. And Why the Last Man, Volume 3. So that was pretty awesome. I still haven't read the first volume yet, but I know I'm going to, like it. So that's why I got that. The next trade I got is an original graphic novel, I believe it is. It's Amazing Spider-Man, Hookie. This is from a while ago. It's Bernie Wrightson and Susan Putney. So yeah, you can't go wrong with Bernie Wrightson. This is from 86. Excuse me. And I believe it's original graphic novel. This looks freaking weird, though. Like, Spider-Man is fighting, like, crazy things. Like, look at that. What is that? And I paid $3 for this, and after I bought it, I realized that there's, like, some damage on the back over here. Like, it's, like, mold damage or water damage or something. I don't know what it is. That kind of sucks, but whatever. It's not that big a deal for $3. But yeah, this looks cool. I'm looking forward to reading this. And, yeah, it's really awkward size, though, so whatever. And then the last few things are some magazines that I got. At MegaCon, I got my first heavy metal magazine. And, so I was looking for some more at Emerald City. And this guy had a few issues for $1 a piece. So I knew I needed them all, so I just grabbed the whole lot. And this one, I don't know what this one is exactly. It looks like an annual or something, like a heavy metal annual, but it's called, I don't know what it is. It's Heavy Metal Overdrive, and it was $1. And this one's from January 92. And this one is from Summer 1988. And this one's from March 1991. So I got four more heavy metal magazines, and then I got this one also. This was in the same lot for $1 also, and this, I couldn't believe it when I saw it, that it was a number one. It's 1984 number one, and this book turned to 1994 at issue 11, and then it went on for like 30 or 40 issues. But yeah, 1 through 10 are called 1984, and this was number one, and that's very surprising that I found this. I mean, I don't know how common it is, but it kind of caught me off guard as, like, wow, it was number one just for $1. So it's kind of 1984 and 94 are kind of in the same vein as heavy metal. So that's why I got those. All right, guys, that's it. We made it through. Oh, actually, I got these, too. These are at the DC booth. They just give them out for free. Every con I've been to with a DC booth have pins, and so I got a Flash pin. I got another Superman pin. I used to have this one, but I lost it. And then I got a Green Lantern pin. So those are cool. And that's it. Alright guys, thanks for watching. Thanks for bearing with me, 40 minutes long, 35, whatever. Yeah, so it was a great con. I was a little sick throughout the con. I got sick on the Thursday night before. But yeah, I got a lot of great stuff. I got a lot of stuff to read. Like, I didn't have enough to read already. But, you know, that's kind of what it is in con season. So, yeah. I'll see y'all on Monday with my reviews of this past week, of my top three reviews at least, and thanks for watching, guys. I'll talk to y'all later.